I started 30 years ago as a T-boy in a studio.
Yeah.
That's all I did. It was a big, big studio in London. And my job was to make tea for everybody. That's what I started doing. It wasn't long, I was lucky. I was about 6 months. So some T-boys were there more than 2 years. If you make good tea, you might be a good producer one day. If you're a producer, it's impossible to listen to records now and say, this is really hit, this is really great, I'm going to do some of that, because it hits the shops in 6 or 12 months' time and then it's old. You can only do what you feel inside you is right for the music, which means not taking into account modern trends or fashions at all. You can't do that.
Well, Gaff Universal, who's directly working with you, Mike Salt, phoned me up and said, Mike, you've got to hear this artist. So eventually we'd sorted out a meeting and he came in and he played me one of Robert's songs, which I said, well, that's a hit record, just hearing it in the demo form was a hit record. It's happened a couple of times over the last, only a couple of times over the last 10 years. One was when I heard a song in rehearsal with Manic Street Preachers called Design for Life. And the other one was when Fran Healy from Travis played me Why Does It Always Rain On Me? Why does it always rain on me? It's very rare.
Mm. Are we looking at the same results for Robert Hood?
Musically, it is as strong, for sure. There's no question about that. And the songs are as strong, and the voice is amazing. All the elements to make it a hit are there.
If you have the possibility of using equipment that has a better sound to it, then people should be using it if possible. And we're using a combination of very modern equipment, Pro Tools, Digidesign Pro Tools, and the old analog vintage equipment, because we have it. I started in 1975, 30 years ago. So I've seen the technology changing now to 90% computer and digital, and it makes making music fun to have all these things at your fingertips to use. I mean, this is the way to record, I really believe. Everything's recorded through this desk, and you can hear that. Dark Side of the Moon, which is, we know it as the Dark Side of the Moon desk, but it's also the Instant Karma desk, which is the most important thing to me. It's one of my favourite records.
It really sounds different from everything else I've recorded.
I think people can actually listen to this record and they'll hear the difference. They'll hear what it does. I found it when I was working at Abbey Road. They were actually changing. It was in the early 80s, and technology was changing, and the modern style consoles, like this big one over here, were coming in. And nobody loved it anymore, and I found it. And several others from Abbey Road as well. I still have it to this day.
Silence makes him sick. The silence. sing.